In these days of corporate wrongdoing and widespread distrust of prominent corporations, large multinational businesses can assume to be criticized from many directions and examined for all kinds of misconduct. For instance, Nike was bested out of selling footwear to distance runners desiring for faster times, and over the past century, they have pursued the next leap forward, assisting to enhance human ability with small advances, with many of them quickly imitated by competitors. The New York City Marathon's champion in 2019 and the quickest marathoner in the world share some things in common. They're both from Kenya, they train together, and wear the same Nike Vaporfly running footwear. Geoffrey Kamworor donned the shoe on November 3 when he completed the New York Marathon in about 2 hours and some minutes. Eliud Kipchoge, who possesses the world marathon record, wrapped a Vaporfly model when he ran the first sub-2-hour marathon ever. In fact, the $300 shoes, which come in light green, orange, and pink, have been included in almost every major running tournament for the past few years. But some athletes and researchers believe the footwear presents an unfair advantage, with both independent and Nike-sponsored pieces of research validating that the shoe enhances athletes' operational efficiency by 6% or more, which produces significant dividends in marathon-length distances. An American runner who finished amongst the top in the 2019 Chicago Marathon gave an update on the footwear, claiming it felt like moving on trampolines. The mystery is the sole of the shoe, which was invented to help runners get the most moving forward for each stride or to run faster using the same energy expenditure. In addition to safeguarding the feet from the impact of hitting the ground, it also liberates energy to launch athletes forward. The meat of the sole serves as a spring, hardening when an athlete lands, saving the energy from the foot strike and increasing again to restore that stored energy into the ground to propel them forward. Traditional trainers typically use ethylene vinyl acetate foam, which returns 1/65 of the energy you place into it, and therefore the Vaporfly against this uses a brand new form of foam, referred to as Pebax, that is regarding 87 economical. The addition of the carbon fiber plate permits the Pebax foam to compress and expand quickly. According to a study handled independently of Nike, it was observed that the Vaporfly shoes increased an athlete's running speed by 4.5% compared to Adidas Adizero Adios 3 shoes. Another study checked out early Vaporfly models in November 2017 and reached constant conclusion. The example shoots down the energy expended in the running by 4% on the average, the research wrote. About 2 years later, the forecast came true. Meanwhile, around October, Kipchoge finished the Ineos Marathon Challenge in Vienna, an exhibition arranged specifically to attempt a sub-2-hour marathon. Kipchoge was acclaimed to be wearing a model of the Nike Vaporfly called Alphafly that hasn't hit the market. Although Kipchoge's below 2-hour marathon race didn't place a new world record because of IAAF rules, he smashed the world marathon history record in 2018, donning the Vaporflies. In September, when Kamworor recorded the fastest half marathon in 58 minutes and 1 second, he was putting on the Vaporflies. The shoes had loads of other fans as well, and in 2019, athletes wearing Vaporflies alleged 31 out of the 36 male and female podium sports in the 6 biggest marathons around the world. Comparing the trend of Vaporfly to the swimming races at the 2008 Beijing Olympics, in which contestants recorded 25 world records, that year, 95% of the Olympic field athletes wore the Speedo's LZR racer swimsuit, a full body sleeve of polyurethane produced to mimic a shark's skin. It was known as technology doping. Even athletes that did not wear Speedo had to make a switch to wearing the suit, else there was no probability of them competing. In 2009, the International Swimming Federation forbade all full-body polyurethane suits, including the LZR. For close to 20 months towards the end of the 2000s, the swimming world went through a golden age. Within 2008 and 2009, more than 150 world records were broken over all distances and strokes. American swimmer Michael Phelps was in his prime, And after the 2008 Beijing Olympics, there remained just four events records that weren't shattered, which includes the men's 1,500 and 400-meter freestyle and women's 100-meter butterfly and breaststroke. Several records set in this period remain today, with swimmers incapable of matching the previous generation's achievements. But the short period of success was sunken into controversy as the swimming's record-breaking periods were largely down to speedo. By the time it became aware of the swimming world at the championship in 2009, FINA had stepped up to the issues raised around the standards of using high-tech swimsuits to defeat the previous best efforts of humans. The governing body examined almost 500 samples of the swimsuits and passed 202 for usage in the event. At the inception of 2010, it launched new guides on the coverage and materials of suits, effectively placing bans on the performance-enhancing technologies. The progress of Nike's trainers has disrupted the running community, with experts saying they improve human performance beyond advancement and amount to doping in technology. Now, ahead of the Olympics scheduled for Tokyo later this year, World Athletics governing body has mediated, declaring new rules on what is admitted from running shoes. The law asserts that starting from April 30, any footwear must have been prepared for purchase for 4 months before it can be used in games and tournaments, and models of it cannot be used during races. More importantly, the governing body of athletics ruled that Nike's Vaporfly footwear and the records that were broken using them would stand, and they wouldn't admit a future pair of Alphafly trainers being used as a trail in the Olympics. The new laws state that the feet of the shoes must not be thicker than 40 millimeters and can't accommodate more than one piece of carbon fiber in the form of a plate. How do you feel these rules would evolve? And how effective will this be with shoemakers? Our fingers are crossed till the Olympics. And with that, we come to the end of today's video. Let us know your thoughts on the controversy behind Nike's Vaporfly shoe down in the comments. Also, make sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel if you're new. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. This video is brought to you by Runners Athletics, makers of the best running sunglasses for men and women. UV-400, polarized anti-fog, ultra-lightweight and equipped with spring flex hinges. These sunglasses will race past the finish line while most others fall short. Gear up for your next adventure at runnersathletics.com.